Well, good evening, everyone, and welcome. We're so looking forward to sharing this program with you tonight. Before we do that, I wonder if I might be so bold as to remind us of our beeping things. We could turn off cell phones and pagers, etc., to silent mode. That would be greatly appreciated. And also, just to remind you, if there's a moment where you feel like you'd like to take a picture, you are so welcome to do so. Be mindful of the people around you, but most importantly, please no flash so that the performers are safe on stage. Before I speak about the program in a little more detail, I'd like to have you help me express some gratitude. There are four important people who have helped to make this program a fulsome experience for all of the young artists in Le Choriste and in Chorale. Nathalie Faché, who sings in Choriste, was a young woman who put together the audiovisual components for this presentation, and I am deeply grateful to her. I'm also grateful to Christina Nazar, who is one of our singers in Chorale, who is navigating voice rest right now, and she is the one actually up in the booth running that audiovisual tonight. I also want to say a very heartfelt thanks to Brian Hart, who was our tireless and dedicated stage manager here at the Don Wright Faculty of Music, and he'll be running the lights for us. He has been an incredible support in putting this program together in a very short amount of time. And finally, the artwork that you see behind me here and also on your program is done by one of our singers in chorale, Heyun Han, and we're so pleased that she has been the designer for our posters so far, and we really appreciate her efforts. I wonder if you might help me say thank you. Tonight's presentation of Music in Word explores how, when faced with struggle, the human spirit seems to be able to find strength. Strength to persevere, strength to endure, strength to find their way back to love. Who could have known when I programmed this concert almost 2 years ago that it would have been of such incredible resonance and consonance at this time for our world? We sing tonight to uphold one of our fellow singers, Deborah Damaso, whose family is navigating a tragic loss. We also sing tonight in celebration and honor of Black History Month. We plan the program to run seamlessly without intermission and without pause between pieces, with a chance to speak a little bit more in detail about the context of what you're going to hear next. So although you are welcome to applaud at any time during the program, I thought I would take a moment here just to let you know of a few things that might help to make for greater context for your experience of the music and the poetry that we're going to present tonight. We begin first with an original composition by a contemporary American composer whose name is Moira Smiley. The Little Road. The little road that calls to question our choices. Will we choose to stay at home in the comfort of what is known, or forge ahead and heed the call of the little road that says go? The choreography of the piece was intentionally designed by the composer to represent journey, gratitude, struggle, and strength. Following James Taylor's The Lonesome Road, we are reminded of the possibility of community to uphold those who may feel disenfranchised or alone through Alison Gerben's rendition of Motherless Child. Indodana is a South African piece that speaks of the suffering we face when hope is lost, when we are in grief. It translates as this: the Lord has taken his son who lived amongst us. The son of the Lord God was crucified. During the piece, you'll hear the choir singing syllables, he le le le, ho lo lo lo, jem jem ja. And they are all meant to be syllables that represent grief, crying, hurt. You'll also hear the choir sing Baba, Baba Jehovah, Father Jehovah. From this piece, we turn our sights to hope, and we pay tribute to Martin Luther King with Bob Chilcott's arrangement of the U2 piece, MLK. Following this, the men of chorale will take up the torch with Joshua James's Cold War, a peaceful song of activism for equality, before the women join them in Serena Ryder's call to action through chorale's final piece, Sing, Sing, Sing. We've spoken much about that piece in our rehearsals as a call to artists to be able to use their creativity and their artistry to give voice to hope. They chorused out their voices in Moira Smiley's Wayfaring Stranger, and then they offer the premiere performance of Canadian composer John MacDonald's Silène's Boat. In this piece, we will hear how Silène harnesses the power of the moon to restore peace and balance to her journey. Makedonska tells the story of the patriarch and the matriarch of a family who, being the last remaining people at a family gathering, find themselves lamenting their family's many troubles. But as their conversation continues, they remember the social dances of their younger years. They rise and dance, recalling how they fell in love and all of the beautiful things that began their family so many years ago. Their heavy burdens and responsibilities melt away. Dancing, they lift each other to joy. Next, we honor Lucille Clifton, an African-American poet whose poetry, To My Girls, is set by American composer Gwyneth Walker. The first movement of the song cycle recounts Clifton's adolescence and the moment of recognition of her seeing her truest self, a tall tree girl, a me girl. We celebrate her motherhood in the second movement, noting her wise words, "Go with grace," as her grown children leave the nest. In the final movement, the theme of sisterhood, both literal, because Lucille is writing about her own experience with her sister, and figurative, as it serves as a poignant affirmation of our shared experience as women. And finally, we honor African-American poet activist Maya Angelou with a reading of her inspiring poem, "And Still I Rise," before the closing of the concert with a piece that offers a very similar message of strength and perseverance. Thank you once again for choosing to be with us tonight. We hope that you'll enjoy the program as much as we've enjoyed preparing it. Enjoy.
what will go down in history as the greatest demonstration for freedom in the history of our nation. We must forever conduct our struggle on the high plane of dignity and discipline. We must not allow our creative protest to degenerate into physical violence. Again and again, we must rise to the majestic heights of meeting physical force with soul force. So even though we face the difficulties of today and tomorrow, I still have a dream. Because I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today. With this faith, we will be able to work together, to pray together, to struggle together, to go to jail together, to stand up for freedom together, knowing that we will be free one day. Let freedom ring, and when this happens, when we allow freedom ring, when we let it ring from every village and every hamlet, from every state and every city, we will be able to speed up that day when all of God's children, black men and white men, Jews and Gentiles, Protestants and Catholics, will be able to join hands and sing in the words of the old Negro spiritual, free at last, free at last. Thank God Almighty, we are free at last.
into a kind of life. I had no model. Born in Babylon, both non-white and woman, what did I see to be except myself? I made it up here on this bridge between starshine and clay, my one hand holding tight my other hand. Come, celebrate with me that every day something has tried to kill me and has failed.
Hey girl, has gone to bed one night another with fear or pain or loss or disappointment. And yet each of us has awakened and risen, somehow made our ablution, seen other human beings, and said, morning, how are you? Finding things in you. It's amazing. Wherever that abides in the human being, there is the nobleness of the human spirit. Despite it all, black and white, Asian, Spanish, Native American, pretty, plain, thin, fat. Vow to celibate, we rise. You may write me down in history with your bitter, twisted lies. You may trod me in the very dirt, but still like dust, I rise. Does my sassiness upset you? Why are you beset with gloom? Just because I walk as if I have oil wells pumping in my living room. Just like suns and like moons, with the certainty of tides. Just like hope springing high, still I rise. Did you want to see me broken? Bowed head and lowered eyes, shoulders falling down like teardrops, weakened by my soulful cries. Does my sassiness upset you? Don't take it so hard just because I laugh. As if I have gold mines digging in my own backyard. You can shoot me with your words. You can cut me with your lies. You can kill me with your hatefulness. But just like life, I'll rise. Does my sexiness offend you? Oh. Does it come as a surprise that I dance? As if I have diamonds at the meeting of my thighs. Out of the huts of history's shame, I rise. Up from a past rooted in pain, I rise. A black ocean leaping and wide, welling and swelling, I bear in the tide. Leaving behind nights of terror and fear, I rise into a daybreak miraculously clear. I rise, bringing the gifts that my ancestors gave. I am the hope and the dream of the slave. And so, naturally, there I go rising.
is true.